Good morning. Today we are going to analyze the forces acting on a bucket of water which is revolving in a vertical circle.
Flippin' physics!
Didn't we do this already?
Yep.
Actually, no. We figured out why water stays in the bucket, but we did not draw free body diagrams and analyze the situation. So, Bo, could you please draw a free body diagram of the bucket of water when the bucket is at the bottom position?
With the bucket at the bottom, the force of gravity is down, and the force of tension is up.
Billy, how about with the bucket at the top position?
Okay, the bucket is at the top. The force of gravity is down, and the force of tension is also down.
Bobby, and how about with the bucket on the side?
If the bucket is on the side, the force of gravity is still down. And actually, the force of gravity is always down, and the force of tension is always inward in every one of these free body diagrams.
That's a very good observation, Bobby. That means it's easier to draw the free body diagram anywhere. Let's add one more for the bucket when it's halfway between the side and the bottom. Again, the force of gravity is down, and the force of tension is inward. Let's start by analyzing the situation with the bucket at the bottom. Bobby?
Well, we've drawn the free body diagram. None of the forces need to be broken into components, so the net force in the in direction equals force of tension minus force of gravity, which equals mass times centripetal acceleration. Force of gravity equals mass times acceleration due to gravity, and centripetal acceleration equals, well, it depends.
Okay, let's assume we know the angular velocity, and let's solve for the force of tension.
Okay, then centripetal acceleration equals radius times angular velocity squared, and solve for force of tension equals mass times acceleration due to gravity plus mass times radius times angular velocity squared.
All right, a couple of things to talk about. First off, Billy, when the bucket is at the bottom, what is the centripetal force acting on the bucket of water?
The centripetal force is the net force in the in direction. So the centripetal force is the force of tension minus the force of gravity.
That is correct. Bo, what happens to the force of tension if I increase the angular speed of the bucket?
According to the equation, if the angular velocity is increased, that will also increase the force of tension.
Also correct. Then, Bobby, what happens to the centripetal force if I increase the angular speed of the bucket?
Well, we know the force of tension increases. The force of gravity will remain the same, so the centripetal force will increase as well.
In other words, a larger bucket angular speed requires a larger force of tension to cause a larger centripetal force to cause the bucket to continue to revolve in a vertical circle.
Mr. P, in the free body diagram where the bucket's at the bottom position, you drew the force of tension arrow longer than the force of gravity arrow. How do you know the force of tension is greater in magnitude than the force of gravity there?
Billy, that is a fair question. It turns out
Mr. P, do you mind if I answer that question?
No, Mr. Beck, I do not mind. Go ahead.
Hello, Mr. Beck.
Welcome.
Hi. Okay, imagine if, as the bucket moved along the bottom of the circle, the force of tension and the force of gravity suddenly became equal in magnitude. Billy, describe the motion of the bucket if they were equal.
What would happen to the bucket? Isn't the bucket moving in a circle?
I think he is implying the bucket would not move in a circle.
If the force of tension and the force of gravity were equal in magnitude, then the net force in the in direction would equal zero.
Right. Then the centripetal acceleration would equal zero, and the bucket would not move in a circle. It would continue in a straight line.
Exactly. If the force of tension and the force of gravity were equal in magnitude, the bucket would have zero acceleration and would continue in a straight line. But it is not moving in a straight line. It is continuing in a circle. Bo, can you explain then why the force of tension must be greater than the force of gravity?
Sure. In order for the bucket to move in a circle, there must be a centripetal acceleration acting inward, because the centripetal force is the force of tension minus the force of gravity. The force of tension must be greater than the force of gravity to cause an inward centripetal force, and therefore an inward centripetal acceleration.
Perfect. My work here is done. I'm out.
Thank you, Mr. Beck.
You are welcome.
If we knew the radius of the path, the mass and angular speed of the bucket and water, we could solve for the force of tension. We could do this at any bucket location, top, bottom, side, or anywhere in between. Notice at a location which is not the bottom, top, or side, we would need to break the force of gravity into its components in the in direction and the tangential direction, just like we did with the toy car and the curved hill. But we don't have a numbers dependency, so let's stop here and not have any numbers in this lesson. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.